Hi everyone, Adam here. That's spelled A-T-O-M. Welcome back to my lab, where we explore the wonders of STEAM. Remember, anytime you would like to visit me, just look up Adam's Lab. Today, we're learning about shapes and sizes. Shapes are all around us, from square slices of bread to the round sun in the sky. Sizes are also all around us, from the tiny ants in our backyards to the giant whales in the ocean. In this video, we'll learn about different shapes and sizes and how to identify them. We'll also learn about the importance of shapes and sizes in our everyday lives. There are many different shapes, but some of the most common ones are circle, triangle, rectangle, square, pentagon, hexagon, and octagon. These shapes can be found all around us, in our homes, at school, and in nature. To identify a shape, we look at its sides and its angles. For example, a circle has only one round side and no angles, while a square has four equal sides and four right angles. An angle is where two sides of a shape come together. To help you better understand this, imagine you are eating your favorite kind of pizza. A slice of pizza has three sides and almost looks like a triangle, but with the crusted end curved. The pointy part of the pizza where the toppings are is where two sides come together to make an angle. Angles are measured in something called degrees. A degree of an angle is simply how close or how far away the two sides are from one another. On a smaller slice of pizza, the two sides are closer to each other, which means the smaller the angle is, the smaller the degree is. On larger slices of pizza, the two sides are farther apart from each other, which means the bigger the angle and the bigger its degree. A small angle might have only one degree, like a tiny slice of pizza. A medium angle might have 45 degrees, like a regular slice of pizza. And a big angle might be 90 degrees, like a giant slice of pizza. A 90-degree angle is also known as a right angle. So if you have a slice of pizza with four equal sides and four right angles, you would have a square pizza. Pretty cool, huh? So next time you eat pizza, politely ask your parents for more angles and lots of degrees. Can you find circles where you are? There are round wheels, plates, coins, balls, and of course, pizza! Circles have only one curved edge and no angles. Even though they don't have any angles, the edges can be broken into smaller sections called arcs. Just like angles, the size of arcs is measured in degrees. The longer the arc, the larger the degree. Whereas, the smaller the arc, the smaller its degree. You might have an arc as small as 1 degree or one as large as 360 degrees, which is a full circle. Triangles have three sides and three angles. Let's count them. One, two, three. Three sides. One, two, three. Three angles. Many things all around us are shaped like triangles. Can you spot some of the triangles where you are? The roofs of many houses, traffic signs, some musical instruments, sandwiches that have been cut at a diagonal, and of course, slices of pizza are all triangles. Triangles can have sides that are the same length and angles that are the same measurement, but some triangles have sides that are different lengths and angles that are different measurements. Rectangles and squares both are four-sided shapes that have four right angles and sides that are parallel to each other, which means the sides are always the same distance apart from each other and never cross over each other. It's like the sides are holding hands with each other. Let's count the sides and angles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four angles. Squares are a special kind of rectangle. All four of a square's sides are of equal length with each other. So all squares are rectangles, but not all rectangles are squares. Pretty cool, huh? How many things can you find where you are that are either rectangles or squares? Doors, windows, books, some tables, and even greeting cards are all shaped like rectangles or a square. Pentagons have five sides and five angles. Can you count them with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five angles. Pentagons can be either regular or irregular. Regular pentagons have all sides equal in length and all angles equal in measure. An irregular pentagon has sides that are of different length and angles of different measurement. Imagine you're building a house with five walls. The walls are all connected at the top, making a pointy roof. That's what we call a pentagon. It's like a little house with five walls and a pointy roof. A regular pentagon is like a perfect little house. All the walls are the same height, and the roof is nice and symmetrical. But an irregular pentagon is like a house that's been built a little bit crooked. The walls can be different heights, and the roof might be a little lopsided. Pentagons are pretty cool because they show up in all sorts of places. You'll find them in math problems, buildings, paintings, even nature. Like, have you ever seen a starfish? They're like a living pentagon. So next time you see a pentagon, take a moment to appreciate its unique shape and all the different places it can be found. And remember, it's all thanks to science that we can understand these cool shapes in the first place. Can you find any pentagons? A hexagon is a shape that has six sides and six angles. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six angles. Like pentagons, hexagons can be either regular or irregular. They're found all throughout nature, from honeycombs to hexagonal patterns of snowflakes, and even the planet Saturn has hexagon-shaped clouds near its north pole. This is because hexagons are really organized and can be compacted together without leaving any gaps or overlaps. Can you think of any hexagons that you've seen? An octagon has eight sides and eight angles. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight angles. Like a hexagon and a pentagon, octagons can be either regular or irregular. Octagons can be found in lots of different places, such as spider webs, open umbrellas, some tables and mirrors, and traffic signs. Like, have you ever seen a stop sign? It's an octagon. How many things shaped like an octagon can you think of? Sizes can be big, medium, or small. We can also compare sizes using words like larger than and smaller than. We can perceive the size of an object by comparing it to its surroundings and other objects. For example, a cat is larger than a mouse, but a cat is smaller than an elephant. Shapes and sizes are all around us. They are important in our everyday lives. They are also important in engineering, construction, and art, and can be described and measured using math. We can figure out the size of objects by comparing them to other objects or to their environments. Imagine you're playing with your giant teddy bear, the one that takes up half of your bed. It's so big that you can hug it all around and still have room left over. Now, think of your tiny ant friend, the one that lives in your backyard. It's so small that you can barely see it crawling across the ground, and you have to use a magnifying glass to see it more clearly. These toys and creatures represent different sizes, and their sizes matter. Your teddy bear is big and cuddly, perfect for snuggling up to on a cold night. Your ant friend is small and quick and able to explore tiny spaces and carry things much bigger than itself. Sizes everywhere you look, from the towering skyscrapers in cities to the tiny grains of sand on the beach. It's something we can use to compare and contrast things, to make sense of the world around us, and to guide our actions and decisions. For example, when you're choosing a toy to play with, you might think about which one is bigger or smaller. Or when you're deciding what to eat for dinner, you might think about which meal is bigger or smaller. Size is also important in science and engineering. Scientists use size to measure and study things, from the tiniest atoms to the largest planets. Engineers use size to design and build things, from tiny microchips to massive bridges. And in nature, size plays a big role on how animals live and survive. Big animals like lions and elephants have different ways of dealing with their size than small animals like ants and insects. So how do we talk about size? We use words like big, small, and medium to describe the size of things. We also use numbers in math to measure size, like centimeters and meters, or inches and feet. We might also use different words to describe sizes. For big things, we might say huge, enormous, or giant. For medium things, we might can say normal, average, or medium. And for small things, we can say tiny, little, or small. But sometimes we need special words to talk about really big or really small things. For really tiny things, we might say that a tiny virus is microscopic because it's so small that you can only see it with a microscope. For really big things, we might say that a star is astronomical or cosmic because it is so big that it's out of this world. Size is an amazing concept that helps us understand the world around us. It's something to think about the next time you're playing with your toys, exploring nature, or learning about science and engineering. And remember, no matter what size you are, you're an important part of this big and wonderful world. Today, we learned about shapes and sizes, and how they're important in our everyday lives. For example, we need to know the shape and size of a screw in order to choose the right screwdriver. We also need to know the shape and size of a piece of food in order to know how to bite it. Shapes and sizes are also important in science and engineering, construction, and art. and we can use math to describe them. Engineers use shapes to design buildings and bridges. Construction workers use shapes to build houses and roads. Artists also need to be very good at identifying shapes and perceiving sizes, as well as the distance of certain objects compared to other objects, in order to draw or paint them properly. Stay curious, keep learning, and remember that STEAM is all around us. Remember, curiosity is like a special key that helps us unlock doors to gain knowledge. But imagination is like a magical power that brings all the amazing things that we can learn to life. It's like looking through a special telescope that shows us new ideas and make our minds grow bigger. Imagination helps us dream, create, and think about things that we can't see with our eyes. So always use your imagination, because it helps you come up with cool new things and discover a world full of wonders. See you next time, my curious minds. Stay eager to learn and have a steamtastic day. Bye-bye!